I felt like it was important to just go ahead and give the students the rundown of like the expectations of the day, what we were trying to accomplish as far as learning objectives, lesson activities and all that. So I felt like it was a good time to just kind of give them the rundown of what's going on for the day before we got into the other part of the lesson. And I feel like that was a great time to quickly go through that and transition to coach for the language lesson.
And I feel like with the new model that Floyd County gave us, it kind of fits in perfectly because right at the beginning, we have that intro kind of mini lesson time, and so I fit really well into there, and then I turn it back over to Coach Campbell, and he gives his kind of mini intro lesson, and then we go straight to our work time. So it kind of just all fits really nicely.
Oh, for the learning objective, I just kind of look at the standard and what we're expected to discuss that week, and then I kind of get with Coach and just kind of give him the idea and say, hey, here's the standard, and like whether it's strand A, B, or C, I'll say, hey, we're working on this week. And that allows him to kind of look at that and kind of form it into a language target.
That's right. Now I just take all my things directly from Coach Campbell's plans and then use the language that he's going to be using in lessons anyway. And we take that vocabulary and take those important language topics and we push those in our language lesson.
Oh, just in the beginning of the lessons, I never have the presence of mind to like realize I've got other people in the room to help, and I try to do it on my own. And that's when it just kind of clicked, and I just kind of passed some of those back on to Coach Myers and Dr. Pendergrass and said, hey guys, y'all mind helping doing that? And it kind of helped things kind of flow smoothly. But for me personally, I had to like stop and think, be like, okay, they're here to help, so let's put them to work.
And from my point of view, I love being in classes where I am put to work. I would much rather be engaged and involved in the class, even if it is just passing something out or passing papers out, doing things that are helpful to the class. I'd much rather do that than just sit and observe. So I was super glad that Coach Campbell put me to work and asked me to do those things, because now it's become just a routine. We help pass out binders. Coach Campbell kind of just says, and Coach Myers is going to pass out the binders, and I go to the back and I pass them out, and it's super seamless and simple.
For behavior management, we kind of had a plan for the beginning of the school year, kind of setting out those expectations and modeling both the correct behavior in the classroom, and we both support each other on that. And he brings in the tickets to reward the students for participating in class. And I typically do the PBIS points when he's not around. So when Coach Myers is in the class, we kind of switch to that ticket system that the students seem to really thrive with and they seem to respond very well to.
And the students do really well. In this class, classroom management is very well taken care of. We rarely have any problems in this class. And a lot of that does have to tie back to students want those rewards, and they, for the most part, do what they need to do. And when we see those things, when we see them standing out in a lesson, we reward them for those things. So my advice to co-teachers that are pushing into another classroom, the first one would be know what to expect and communicate that well. So the teacher that you're teaching with doesn't know the expectations that you have, then it makes the rest of the year tough, because things will kind of fall into place and they might not exactly be how you want them to be, but it's a lot more challenging to change them towards the middle of the year than it is if you come in with those expectations already set. The other thing is to be flexible. Being flexible is also something that can help you out as a co-teacher.
My advice would be to classroom teachers, just kind of have an open mind and just come in and understanding that they're coming in here to kind of help you address your standards and kind of help you with your class. And for us, it's been really great because Coach Myers brings a lot of energy and enthusiasm to the classroom, so we have a good thing going. But if there's maybe something that went that you didn't maybe agree with or didn't like, just have a conversation, say, hey, let's kind of attack it from this angle. So it's just kind of having an open mind, it's kind of giving them a chance and just understanding that they're there to help your students, they're there to help you address your standards as well.
Five times?
I would say about five times, about just kind of recap what we did and what went really well, and if there was changes, and changes we could kind of implement in there, and it was kind of being sure that we're matching our energy level in the classroom, so just good meetings. I wasn't really nervous. I was very comfortable.
I mean, as well. I was comfortable, and I think they were always interesting because there were always things that I didn't really think about, and it was like, oh yeah, we could tweak that and make it a little bit better, and they were super helpful in that aspect.
I personally love the co-teaching method and the experience. I think it's great to have multiple teachers in the classroom because, like I said, we're working together to educate our students and teach our standards and do the things that we normally have to do. So it's been very exciting for me.
I've loved seeing, even on like a Monday morning at 8 a.m., some of the energy from the students, especially in this class. It's, I come in sometimes with, and I have to kind of hype myself up and build the energy up. And Coach Campbell always comes in with energy just out the door. And so it's always good to kind of get some energy from Coach Campbell and then help share that energy with the class. And it really does carry over, I think. And when we start with energy, usually the class usually goes really smooth and it goes really well, and the kids are excited to learn, and that's been a super positive experience for me.
Okay, so we at Coosa Middle School, we do the Love, Teach, Learn is kind of been our motto this year. We've really implemented that in the class because I believe with the students is we can get a lot accomplished together once we do kind of follow that, because when you're dealing with them and they understand that they make mistakes and we get onto them for that, well, they still have to know that you love them, and that is the biggest part of what we're trying to accomplish here at our school, because students will respond much better to you knowing that anything that happens, whether it's discipline or anything, is coming from a place of love. And once they know that you do have that love for them and you do care about them, it kind of makes all the other issues easier to deal with.
Yeah, I definitely think the students in this classroom know that we care about them, know that we love them, and know that even if we do have to resort to discipline, it is because that we love them. And I think that takes care of the other two. When they understand that, the teaching and the learning part come a lot easier. And even for us, I mean, I've enjoyed being in Coach Campbell's room because I like learning teaching styles and things like that from him, and how to deal with certain situations. So the teaching and learning for everybody in that environment is better when the love part's there at the beginning.
Yes, my name is Joseph Pethel. I'm the principal here at Coosa Middle School. One of the things that we really try to do is we actually have a kind of a logo that we've created here. One of our teachers, Ms. Brumbelow, actually designed this, so I want to give her credit for that. But the logo is pretty simple. It's a pyramid structure. At the bottom, you'll see love as the foundation of that. Teach and then learn. And then, of course, we have our Coosa C at the top. And it's important that we realize that love is the biggest word in this, because it is hard to be taught from somebody that you don't trust and respect to be able to teach you the right things. And it's certainly hard to learn without being taught. So that really has become our vision at Coosa Middle School, something that we talk about all the time. Matter of fact, I had a student just put this on my desk today of the structure. So, you know, it is something that I believe the community is beginning to understand. I believe that our teachers and students are beginning to be a process of. So it's something that we're very proud of, and it's simple, but it is something that has always been our North Star as we move forward, to make sure that no matter what the challenges are, our vision is still the same. It doesn't matter whether it be co-teaching in the ELL setting, or whether it be teaching a resource class, or teaching a regular education class, or a gifted class. That is always what we start with. It has to come with a relationship first, and then the instruction and the learning can go from there. So really, love, teach, learn is what we're about, and we're really proud of that as a model as we move forward.